This is the day that the Lord has made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. I want you to know that we are so glad to have you with us tonight. Thank you for opening up your home for us to come and be with you. We are so glad, so happy that every Wednesday you invite us to your home. I don't know whether you invite us or we come. We come. And then you welcome us. And we come with joy, we come with peace, and even change the atmosphere in the house. I don't know how your day has been. I don't know what battles you have been going through, but you can be glad that we have come tonight through Open Talk. Now, Open Talk is a program that is brought to you by your pastor and your friend for a long time, Bishop Mark Kariuki. And in Open Talk, the purpose is to bring information, maybe to bring in correction, reproof, rebuke, and any other information that you will capture. It is your responsibility as the viewer to glean from the treasures that you get in Open Talk. Because we're bringing guests who will come up with experiences that will transform your life. And tonight, I want you to know, you are in for a cool time. Because you could be watching this program and you are at the bottom of the pit. You are saying, me, I have gone down, 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 until I hit the bottom. And you are there at the bottom. We are coming to tell you there is a way out of the bottom. You are in for a great time because we have a great guest with us tonight who is going to speak to us, and your lives will never be the same again. Now, our guest tonight is Mr. George Wachiori. Mr. George Wachiori is the CEO of Optiven. Welcome, George, to Open Talk. In Open Talk, you talk or I talk. Or we hear one another and we move on. And you will get to know him a little bit more, those of you who do not know him. But he is the CEO of Optiven, and Optiven is a known real estate company in this nation. And maybe you are looking for a shamba, maybe you have an opportunity to get yourself a shamba, maybe you have an opportunity to get yourself a house. But what you will notice is that if he had stayed at the bottom, he would have been baptized a failure. But he looked at the painting that was on the all around the wall at the bottom, and he refused to be baptized a failure. Anyway, before we get into that, George, welcome to Open Talk.
Wow. Yeah,
I want you to just, why don't you just bring greetings to the people?
Wow, thank you very much. I am extremely humbled, very excited to be on this One Accord TV. This is my favorite TV. Every evening on Wednesday, Minakatu Pale, listening to the Bishop. And the Bishop, I value you. We at Optiven, we value you. You have done an amazing job with this particular country, and I am so honored. I don't take this for granted that I'm here talking to the people, and of course, you interviewing me. And I'm very humbled that today's sharing is going to inspire somebody. Today's sharing is going to put some energy in people's minds, because what God can do, we cannot even imagine, because God is amazing, amazing. If George is here, there is God in heaven. A young boy from Kieni. Bishop, do you know Kieni?
Kieni.
Kieni is the most dry place in Nyeri. And people in my days, they hated the place. Actually, in the secondary school, it was called Juakari. So I was baptized Juakari.
Oh. So, viewers, you are in for a cool time. Introducing to you Juakari. So those of you who thought nothing can come out of Kieni, mm-hmm. You are in for a shock. Just as those of you who thought nothing good would come out of Elbagon. Mm-hmm. Elbagon, you know, you come from a dry place.
Yes, yeah.
I come from a wet, cold place.
Eish.
It was bad news. And you know, when we went to school,
yes.
We had no shoes.
Oh,
and
my.
Walking on the Maram,
Eish.
In the morning, 8,000 feet above sea level, at times the road is white.
Wow.
Is white.
And now you're here.
And we thought somebody had poured some unga on the road. Kubet was not unga.
Oh my.
It was that frost. But
wow.
We made it. We made it in
God
the name of the Lord.
Amen.
Okay, now, you were born in Kenya.
Yes.
Kenya is in Nyeri.
Yeah, Kenya is in Nyeri. Mm. I was born there. And we were a family of eight. and we lost our father when we are all young. Mm. And the firstborn was in Form 1. I was not even to Class 1 because our place, there was no nursery school. Mm. So you are going straight to Class 1. And my mother was not educated, and my uncles disappeared completely. And we were there in Kieni, and there were a lot of challenges. Number one, there was no food because every time we planted, Kieni is dry. Mm. And life was very difficult. And we were there, the eight of us, you know, sometimes going without food, not for one day, not for 2 days. I remember one day in 1984, for 5 days, we had not eaten anything. And for the first time, we were almost eating leaves. And thank God for His Excellency, the late President Daniel Moi, because he brought the white maize. That's how we survived, by the grace of God. And life was very tough. And remember, we are eight of us. My mother is not educated, was a class four. My late mother died 1 year ago. And going to school was like a miracle. You know, you go to school, you cannot raise 20 shillings for primary school. So you're in school, half you're at home. By the grace of God, I went up to class 8, and I knew I had no role model, no mentor. So I knew after class 8, I want to go and be a hands boy. You know, I get that 100, 150 shilling salary. But the first time I did class 8, I failed. Mm-hmm. Because no motivation. But a year earlier, I had seen my brother go to Kenyaga High School, and he was bought a trouser. I remember it was black with some stripes. Mm-hmm. The mind came. That means if I pass, I'll get this trouser. Mm. I do away with the ones that they don't have anything at the back, you know? Mm-hmm. And I started working so hard after repeating class 8. Mm. By the grace of God, I passed. In fact, when I was going to do for a check for the exam, I had some women, my mother's age mates, doing, Georgina had to kill it.
They are called gemis.
Yeah, gemi. Mm. So I went there and I found I was the top. I said, God is God of miracles. What happens? I was called to a high school. Mm. When I went to high school, I knew for sure I cannot get fees. The fees was 3,080. Mm. And basically, the man was not there. Mm. But my mother was a very, very, she was a people person. Mm. She called for Harambee. And I remember women coming there with 5 shillings, 2 shillings. We raised 700. I went to Shiga Boys. Mm. Going to Shiga Boys, it was a boy who is under the weather. I saw clean people, good people. Mm-hmm. And I said, wait a minute, I think this is like heaven. You know, it's in Odhaya, from Kieni to Odhaya.
Yeah.
And I went there with a lot of challenges. There was no fees. Sometimes I'm chased away to go home. And I was half in school, half at home. By the grace of God, in Form 4, I said, now, me as George Washiri, I don't want to go back to Kieni. Mm. I worked so hard, and it came a time whereby people were choosing courses. Mm. I did not know which course to choose. My father was a teacher, so I always wanted to be a teacher. Mm. Of course, I did, B.Ed, KU. Mm. But when I checked my friend there, I saw he had written something, B.com. Ah, the name is good, B.com. Mm. Ah, I copied it. Mm. Yeah, I copied on my form. Mm. I put teaching second, BCom first. That's how I joined Bachelor of Commerce in Wakabete Campus, University of Nairobi. Uh-huh. I did not know what is Bachelor of Commerce. Today, the guy I copied from is now very senior in Isuzu Motors. I think he's one of the directors there. Mm. And when I went to Kabete Bishop and our viewers, for the first time I saw people being dropped with yani big cars and neat cars. George is there. I don't know where to start from. I did not know Nairobi. And I said, my God, will I finish school here? I was a very staunch Catholic. Mm. But the second week, I was very disturbed, even to see the environment. Mm. And I heard people singing. I said, today, the people are singing, I'm going there to just to pray and feel as if I'm in another environment. Mm. That was Christian Union. Mm. What? Wait until the time I said I'm from Nyeri. There were some people there who are from Nyeri. Mm. After the Christian, you know, they followed me and they picked me up and took me to their room. Mm. I remember a bro called Kapenguria. Mm. That guy later on became my best man. It's called Mr. Kashoya. Mm. They really talked to me. Please, George, give your life to Jesus, because even as we are here, we are now clearing university and we are born again. Mm. Ah, for about 5 hours, I said, these guys are not leaving me alone. They don't know I'm a staunch. Mm. Ah, I said, just to please them, let me get born again. Yeah. I accept Jesus. Mm. I knelt down. They prayed for me. Mm. Today, Many years later, George Washiri is born again. And I have no regrets at all. And God has been faithful. But of course, going there in Wakabete, life was not easy. Because that's the time the government stopped funding. And we were to pay the fees. Going back home, my mother was telling me, didn't have Besha. I said, wait a minute, what can I do with these clean people, neat people? And an idea came, what if I become a photographer? So I persuaded my brother to buy for me a camera. There was those Bishop, those cameras called Yashika, Idia Kuzungusha. My brother bought me one. I became a photographer. Every time we go for missions in Mombasa, Kapenguria, where I was capturing the moment when people are getting born again. After the mission, I produced the films. Those are the days of the films. I had a deal with a Muindi in town. I sell those photos 10 bob. I remember one time I had sold photos worth 20,000 shillings. Yani pesa tasirimu Bishop. I have never seen such kind of money. I also discovered these students have got money. I also discovered these brothers who are born again, they are neat, they are clean. What can I do for them? I started washing people's clothes. So you bring your clothes, I wash them, I had an aisle box, I earn them, and they charge you 30 bob. I also discovered people in the university of Wakapeta is far from town. They need something to read. I packed up Christian magazines in my small room. You come to read it, I charge you 1 bob. Ukisherewa kurudisha, a fine of 50 cents. So I had 3 businesses. And then the fourth one, I discovered people like being smart. I bought a kinyozi, I was a barber, I was shaving people.
Wow.
That's how I raised my university fees. And for 4 years, I was okay, I had money to support even my mother. One time I went home in Kieni with a shopping for my mother. And my mother asked me, Kaiwe Moishi, where are you getting the money from? I said, no, I'm doing business. And my mother was worried. Nyokodoma, are you going to really make it? I said, yes. By the grace of God, I was able to get a good grades. But I panicked in the fourth year because I knew. Those are the days people are saying there were no jobs. And I knew now, George, you have done your BCom. You are going back to Kieni. And I knew the taboo. Zile zikopale Kieni. I picked my four people. I told them, let's now start looking for a job. I remember those days were no emails. I did 300 job applications. Yani kuandika na mkono Bishop. And then we divided the city. Me was given Babadogo and the industrial area. We said, you go this way, go this way. When you're going to drop the letters, you have 4 letters. 3 for your friends and 1 for yourself. I remember I dropped. You are hungry. And I remember this case of Ushumi supermarket. I went there, I was hungry, I dropped the 4 letters. The watchman abused me. Young man, nani mekwambia hapa kuna kazi? Nikafukuzwa. I pleaded, please, these 4 letters, just give these 4 letters to the human resource. Bishop, that's how I got my first job. I was called for an interview. I was hired as an accountant. And I told God, thank you. And of course, after campus, I got that job. You know, later on, I joined Kakuma refugee camp. I was in charge of logistics there. I worked in Kakuma for about 4 years, left Kakuma, went to IOM, Somalia. I worked in Somalia, Wajid, Bwale, with these Somalis. And remember one time I went to the Bible, I was almost killed because those fellows, it was illegal to carry the Bible in Somalia. And that, it's a story of another day. I've captured it here in this particular book. And later on, I joined UNICEF. And then 08, I now left employment permanently to business. And the story is now very different. And going to business, of course, I was very excited because I really admired business people.
You know what I'm capturing? I'm seeing you at the university.
Yes.
Barbering people's heads.
Yes.
I'm seeing you. I'm seeing these 5 guys. Were they 5 or 4?
You are 4, yes.
4 guys from Nyeri, from the Christian Union, who took you into a room. And I'm thinking about these students, our university students, if they would be doing the same, how many lives we would be able to change?
Many
lives.
Yes, many lives.
Instead of going to the university and you're just there compromising, when you become serious, you will change lives, and those lives will remember you forever.
That's true.
We have evidence here. Who was changed by people who are persistent,
yes,
who are not giving up.
Mm.
They're saying, no, you must give your life to Jesus.
Yes.
You must give your life to Jesus. Because this is what we have been called to,
yes,
to do,
that's
to
true,
to be witnesses.
Mm.
And then I see the zeal and the entrepreneurship in you as you did different businesses.
Mm.
Maybe when you are doing that, people are laughing at you.
Of course, I was a laughing stock. Because washing people's clothes, shaving people, you know, it was demeaning.
Mm.
But I had no choice, because if I'm not demeaned, I'm not, people don't talk about me, I go back to Kieni.
Mm.
Because my mother had no money to pay for me fees. So I had to raise my fees in the proper manner. And God bless those businesses, because the time I was clearing the university, Professor Ishaga, who was the vice chancellor, awarded me as the entrepreneur of the year.
Wow.
I got a trophy.
Yeah.
And that was extremely inspiring.
Mm.
And I really thank God.
Wow.
Yes.
So business did not just start the other day in you.
I think I feared poverty. So the fear of poverty pushed me to business. But of course, now after the now resigning completely from employment, I'm a believer of a saver. I believe that every person who is watching us should be able to apply this principle. 70, 10, 10, 10. 10% you tithe. You give it to God, because this is not your money. 10, and I practice it. 10% you tithe. 10% you save. Even if you're earning 10,000, 10% you tithe, 10% you save. 10%, the other 10%, sort out your insurances. Ensure you have a personal accident cover. Ensure you are saving on an insurance. And then 70%, jibambe. Nunua tai, nunua suti, jipange.
Yeah.
And I believe that when I was very young. So the time I was living in employment, I had saved 5 million shillings.
Five million shillings.
Mm. And now I was telling people, now, mimi sasa naingia biashara. I'll teach you how business is done. I think that was to my detriment. And I came out here and I saw a very beautiful opportunity for real estate.
Mm.
I went somewhere, found a good piece of land, and we agreed, and I was paid deposit.
Mm.
I paid the deposit, and the balance was come from financial.
Mm.
Once I paid the deposit, of course, now you get the title. Take it to the financial. When financial does the search, the search doesn't come out.
Mm.
When I do the search is coming out.
Mm.
So there was kizungumkuti.
Mm.
And I asked the people, how comes when I do the search, inatoka? When the bank does, haitoki. I think I was stupid. I did not know that people can talk to other people in the offices when they see George Washiri inatoka. When it is the real thing, doesn't come. To cut the long story short, it was a fake title. When the guys discovered it was a fake title, they closed their offices. They disappeared. Up to today, Bishop, I have not seen those guys. There were three men. And Bishop, let me tell
you,
lost the money.
You have saved the money.
Yes.
You have bought some land.
Yes.
They've given you a title.
Fake.
Only to discover it is fake.
Fake.
Then they disappear.
They disappear. Completely. They close the office. I remember one time, I used to go to their office every day, consistently for almost 2 to 3 months. Just go to see whether they have appeared. They are not there. Later on, I discovered, I think I should have gotten that the office was small. It was one desk. And life became very difficult because you have no money. You have no job. You have no savings. Not 1 month, not 2 months, a whole year. Actually, we literally closed the office. My office was Uhuru Park with my Bible, a pen, and a notebook. I remember one time I told God, God, if you reinstate me back to real estate, number one, I'll serve you. Number two, I'll never be proud. Number three, I'll open a foundation to support the less fortunate. And it's as if heavens were shut. Nothing was happening. At some point, Bishop, I had no money to come to town. I was trekking to town, this town. No money to eat. Thank God my wife was there for me. My pastor, Reverend Katutu, was also there for me. I lost all the friends. And for 1 year, life was tough. My children moved from a good school to a very low-level school. And it was tough for 1 year. But one time, I asked God, now, me, I will never do business again. Never. Me, I will now want to go back to employment. I picked my CV. You know, CV was good. George has done CP up to K, BCom. I had done my master's in strategy. And I now started applying for jobs. Let me tell you, Bishop, no response even to say, dear George Washuri, we regret we don't have an opportunity. Mm. All the applications I sent, nobody spoke to me. It's as if the heavens were shut.
Mm.
But one time there was a mission in a Tumaini house, and I said, let me go to church just to console myself. Mm. There was this pastor from South Africa called Didi Shauke, and there was preaching there, and the guy preached. And I said, for sure, I'm going to get born again, though I'm born again.
Yeah.
But the guy said, there's somebody here who is going to pay for me my air ticket to South Africa. I found myself in front, kneeling down. Then the pastor prayed for me. You be like Joshua. You led money. You build houses. Now the job I do. When the prayer ended, nobody talked to me. Even my wife did not ask me, did you hear what the pastor said? Why did you go in front? Yet, my pastor knew my situation. That's why he's going to share your issues with your pastor. Even pastor did not ask me, did you hear what the Didi Shauke said? So I went to church on the following Sunday. The same pastor called me. The same wordings that he prayed over me repeated. That night, I remember it was a Sunday night, an idea came. George, go back to real estate. I said, how? I just lost money. It's 1 year, no job, no money. So an idea came, go back to real estate. So I called my brother, we worked together. We went to Kitengela, just to see what is happening right there. And I remember seeing one property there, talking to an agent, said, hey, I told the agent, give me a number for this, the owner of this shamba. Sema, no, nini na wajua. Nikupatie number, upigie mwenyewe, I lose a deal. Kambia, no, if we buy, I'll tell you. That time the thoughts were coming. I had like a small car, nikasema, I can sell this small car. That time it was not moving and moving. Maybe I can resuscitate my friends, I borrow money, I pay a deposit, and I start marketing this property. That idea came, pop! Good enough, miracles now started happening. The broker gave me the number for the owner. I called the owner. Hey, dear one, so he was a doctor. He told me, oh, we can meet at Silver Spring. So I went to Silver Spring. When we went there, we found the doctor with the wife taking tea. Of course, you know hotels, when you go to hotels, you're also given tea. So we started talking. But the doctor was really doubting this young man with the dry lips. The shoes were dusty. And you know, Bishop, when you have issues, anybody can tell that you have issues. And then the doctor asked me, are you the broker? Are you the buyer? By the way, who are you? Because I'm the buyer. The doctor did not believe. In fact, he told the wife, let's go. Every party to pay for their tea. Bishop, say my embarrassment. To cut the long story short, because it's here in this book. We stayed there for 3 hours, looking for somebody to save us. The bill was 250. How I did it, you must read this book. You read this book and say, if George is speaking to Bishop Mark Kariuki, the same God can speak, can do something to you. Talk of embarrassment. The story is here, it's a long story. Because the long story short, I'm not a person who just give up. The following day, I called the same doctor. Hey, Doctor, by the way, we want that 5 acres. Hey, young man, do you have money? Yes, I have money. How much? Have a million. No, I need a million. Immediately, I say, this doctor, and I agree, I put my car on the newspaper, the one for one line, the one who used to pay 70 bob. The first miracle, we sold the car. So I have a small deposit, but not enough to pay the doctor. I remember that a friend, I called him, please, can you lend me some money? Kasema, if I lend you, you pay me 5% per month. That is 60% per year. Kasema, yes, bring the money. So we're able to raise the deposit. The time we paid the deposit for that 5 acre in Kitengela, the miracles started happening. I remember calling my friends for Atumaini to launch the project. Only 3 people came. My wife, myself, and one more guy. And we had balloons. Tukapasua balloons. The project is called Opulent Gardens. The Opulent Gardens is now officially launched. Watuata to Bishop. But I had no money to print brochures. I was going to a cyber, print the prices, and I started my church. I remember one elder, I can mention him because he's okay, he's called Elder Mark. Elder Mark bought two plots. Mm. And today he tells me, I will actually buy to, no, I did not want land to promote you. Mm. And that opened a door for us. And everybody I went to talk to, they were buying, we were selling at 350. Mm. For the first time, the account at Equity Bank started reporting money, getting money. And I was called by the manager, hey, George, kwani umefufuka? Tunaona you have money here. Kasema, there's a property we are selling because we had promised the daktari, give us 3 months. Give us permission to enter the land, and then we sell, we pay you. Within 2 months, 40 plots were sold out.
Wow.
That was the first miracle, Bishop. The second miracle, now the bank is calling me.
Hey,
give us a property, we finance you. Next to that 5 acre, there's another 5 acre for a Muindi. We paid a deposit and sold it. The second miracle. 4 months, we had sold another 5 acres. Now the account is becoming better. And Bishop, today, from that day up to today, we have seen miracles upon miracles happening with Optiven. Today, Optiven is number one company in Kenya, in real estate. Not because George is a professor, but it's because we partner big with God's work. We partner big in supporting communities. Right now, our foundation is among the top five a good foundation in terms of supporting children to go to school, supporting the girls for sanitary wear, supporting the environment, and because there's a promise I made at Uhuru Park. I also said the money I sell my books, because this book is very popular, sold like an eagle, George Washiri's story. The money that I sell this book, the entire money, I don't eat a cent. The money goes to the foundation. The other book is called How to Start Small and Build an Empire Like Optiven, 1,500. The money from this book goes to the foundation. And by God's grace, we are always printing these books. If you go to Amazon, people are buying these books. The money support the foundation. Why? Two things. Because number one, if you partner with God, God will always open doors for you. Number two, if you support the communities, the orphans, the less fortunate, God will always open doors for you. If you support God's work, and that's why I tell all my friends, if you are not tithing, there's a problem. If you're not supporting church project, there's a problem. And they, of course, Bishop know more than me that even the Western countries, the reason why they give to Africa, they know when you give, you also get. And for us, as George Washiri, I am a testimony that this has happened to Optiven. This has happened to you. As we talk, we have done over 70 projects, big projects. We have empowered over 10,000 people to have their own homes. And the company is still growing. Right now, we are talking about Optiven joining Nairobi Securities Exchange, whereby our viewers, you can buy a share from Optiven in the next 3 years. We are starting with our staff. We are giving our staff ESOP. Employees shares ownership plan. They own Optiven. Why? We are looking at Optiven for years to come to be a company that outlives George Washiri. And it's very humbling, and I know there is God in heaven. I'm a moving testimony.
Wow. That is quite a story from where you have started and go and serving God. Because you see, when we serve God, we make God an equal partner. He cannot undercut you. He cannot deceive you.
Yes.
He cannot steal from you. He will give you even much more.
Yes.
I wish many of us in business would capture that. Now tell us, when did you get married and how did you get married? I heard you mention your wife.
The year 2001, April 16th, I got married to one and only Mary Washuka. We now work together. She is one of the directors in Optiven, and she is an amazing lady, very hardworking, down to earth. She loves people, and she was also in Gabete. She has done a Bachelor of Commerce, and she is the one who manages our finances. I'm good in marketing. She is good in managing money. So we work together. And also my brother Charles, we also work together. The one who bought me a camera, remember?
Okay.
We also work together.
Ah.
Yes, Bishop.
Okay.
Yeah.
And you have children?
Yeah, we have two boys. Two boys and one girl. The girl is Nyawira. Nyawira is my late mother. The boy is Washiri, my father. My surname is Kariuki. And then Alex Wangai, man of God. And, you know, this year also we saw a lot of miracles. My son was got an airplane. He got an airplane. And God surprised us because we sponsor a lot of students. We have about 2,000 students that sponsor across Kenya. And this boy, when he got an airplane, he also got a full scholarship to join the University of Strathmore Business School, a course of his choice.
Wow.
You know, costing us about 2 million a year. So we said, God is still doing miracles. And I was telling my wife, the same way we sponsor children, because we have children in Maranda, in Wasungishu, in Mombasa, in Kilifi, we even have some children that are Muslim that we sponsor. Because we want them to learn that even a Christian can sponsor. And when they call them to come to Kenya, our pastors preach to them. So I think God alituonea tu huruma akasema hata mimi niwabariki na huyo. So it's God of miracles. And we thank God.
You know, a lot of people think that to start a business, you have got to have a big capital. What would you say to some of those young people who are saying, I have no capital. Pastor, niombe sina capital, niombe sina capital.
I think to start a business, because for me, even before venturing into real estate, I tried other businesses. You know, I have done a car hire that flopped, you know. And I think that was a very serious experience because I was arrested. You know, I was hiring cars to people. And I was this guy who came and hired the car, paid me for 3 months. I did not know that he was doing the bad business. He was actually carrying bangi.
Oh.
Bang. So the car was arrested in Naivasha. You know, I was watching news. I see my car there, Mitsubishi. You know, one dead, one arrested, the car in the police station. Just to see it's our car. The following morning, I was arrested. Put in and say, young man, what business are you doing? No, I said, no, me, I do business of Kahaya. And then the CID asked me, give us a contract. Bishop, thank God, and I want to address business people. Never do any transaction without a contract. If there was no contract, I would be rotting in jail, in Kamete. That contract saved me. Because we had a contract, we had a copy of the check, the one that the guy paid us, and the photo of the guy. Though I went to a police cell, but once they saw the contract, I was released. And I always encourage people, have a contract. And it was a tough business. It was chaotic. And that was the first incident. The second incident, somebody also hired my premium car and sold it.
Oh.
Producer, a copy title, sold it. When the time ended, I'm looking for a car. It had a car track. I saw a car somewhere in Lavington. To go there, the red told me, no, this is my car. I bought it. Cash.
Wow.
Give us the logbook. The logbook is there. Yet my logbook was with a bank, the real logbook. So there was a case there. But the lady lost money. Why? She could not trace the seller. She had no contract. And she had paid a new premium. Hey, Bishop, amelipa 500 na amelipa cash. Mimi nikapata gari yangu after a case. And then she lost the money. I closed that business for Kahaya. And I said, I respect people who do Kahaya. God bless you, it's a good business. But Washuri, I suffered. I said, now, Kahaya is not good. Let me do water packaging. I did a nice partnership with a gentleman, and we were packaging water. And me, I was in charge of marketing. The guy was in charge of money. And me, I trust people quickly, Bishop. So we said, any party can sign the account. Until one morning, the guy switched off the phone. And something clicked. Let me check whether the account has money. The guy had withdrawn all the money.
Wow.
And I went where the factory was. And the guy told the watchman, if George comes here, kill him. Thank God, every time I was going there, I was giving the watchman 50 bob. Were it not for that relationship with the watchman, ningegongo hapa, Bishop. Ningekuwa hapa. Up to today, I've never gone to that factory.
And
the business collapsed. I know maybe the guy is watching this show. I don't know where you are. You went with the money. I have forgiven you. And God bless you. And then I could ajirika. We closed the business. I said, now, the best business now, it's making shampoo. You know, and this is what we did with our brother. And we had a car shop in Gala making shampoo. And we were selling these shampoos in every salon. Wait until the competition came. We could not sell our shampoo. We closed. And I have done over 15 businesses.
15?
Optiven is the 16th one that failed. I have done cosmetics. I have done beauty. And the whole story is where, Bishop, here. Some of those experiences inspire people and also advise people what you must do. And then I pick those lessons and put them in this particular book. What do you require for you to run a successful business? And I yes, I failed, but they also say the reason why I failed 15 times, number one, I had no mentor. Somebody you're asking, hey, Bishop, I want to start this. What do you think? And that's why I tell people that always find a mentor. And for me, as George Washiri, I have a school called George Washiri School of Mentorship. I do Zoom, online Zoom, twice in a month. The first cohort, they graduated. Now we are doing the second cohort of 500 people who log in on my Zoom, George Washiri School of Mentorship. And you can find it on my YouTube, George Washiri. Why? I know the pain of failing. And I don't want any Christian business person to fail like George Washiri. That's why mentors come in. That what I experience, you don't need to experience that. Why? We are here. That's why we document our stories to help people. Do you have a contract? Do you have a vision? Do you have a structure? Do you hire the right people? Don't hire relatives. I tell people, hire people you can fire. If you hire relatives, ensure they are competent, like what I saw here. People are competent, not because somebody is looking for a job. From KNE, you hire them. You will fail. And I teach people all these aspects. How to manage money. Optimum money is not George Washiri's money. Me, I'm on salary.
Yeah.
You know? And optimum money is optimum money. And we teach people all those things through mentorship because, Bishop, failing is expensive. It is painful. It is not easy, Bishop.
But seeing you here, you can confidently tell somebody who is watching that failure is not final.
Yeah, in fact, they say that failure is not the opposite of success. Failure is part of success because when you fail, you pick lessons. And these lessons will help you to prepare you to the next level. Right now, Bishop, me, I value people. Whether you are a sweeper, whether I value everyone. That's why for us at Optiven, we say, you know, our slogan is, I value you. Because people buy people. And those who are in businesses, Bishop, we had asked, what business can people start? When I look at Kenya today, I see zillions of opportunities, what people can do. Right from businesses that you can start without capital. There's something called social capital. Social capital is our network. Like now here we are networking.
Yeah.
That's social capital. With social capital, you can do business. I remember one of the businesses I did, I had no capital. And I was going to industrial area. I pick tissue bills. I leave my ID with a Muindi so that Muindi trust me that Sita Potea na mali yake. I go hawking. I hawk this tissue shop to shop. In the evening, I have sold maybe 80%. Return, the returns, plus the money and my margin. And I was making some money. What did I require? I only required the physical energy. I only required my mouth. So there are many businesses we only require the abilities God has given us. Because God has given us the energy capacity. God has given us the thinking capacity. You only need to think. God has given us the relationship capacity. How do you treat people? And God has given us creative capacity that you can be able to check. Can I be creative to make money? And I'm happy that most of our young people, they are using all these God-given abilities to create wealth. And they are making it. You only require a smartphone to open a shop nowadays. You only require a smartphone. You open a shop. Maybe you're doing bags. You are doing design clothes. You are doing stuff right here. And they are saying, today's consumer, they are checking online first how the items cost. Even us at Optiven, 50% of our sales, they come from Facebook. 50%, they come from Google Ads. Why? This is an asset. So you don't need that big money to start big business. You only need to have that those thoughts. I call it, you think big and start small and start now. You think big, start small, start now. Don't wait for tomorrow, bro, because procrastination is the killer of our vision. Once you procrastinate, there's no right time to start a business. There is no right time to start your career. And also address the career people who are out there. You know, you are working for somebody. You're working for an office. Do you make yourself relevant? Even this time of COVID, can your employer trust you? Can you call your employer? First of all, you encourage your employer and tell them, by the way, give me some work. I'm at home. I have a laptop. I can work. Make yourself relevant. Once you are relevant, definitely no employer want to lose a relevant person. Be passionate on what you do. That whatever you do, if there are people who are taking out videos, be passionate about it, like it, love what you do, and then definitely all the time pray. Yani, every day you wake up in the morning, kneel down, pray, tell God today is a good day. Something good is going to happen. Like today, this morning, I prayed. I even prayed for you, Bishop. I said, today, this show is going to be to inspire people. Anoint my lips as I speak that somebody will hear this story. They are going to change. Prayer works. And then definitely, you really need to work hard. You know,
work hard.
You really need to work hard. Because nothing comes easy. Yes, pray and work hard. I ask people, if you find yourself waking up after six, I don't need to be a prophet, you'll be poor. Because people who are controlling the world, by 5:30, by 5, they are awake. They say the globe is controlled by 5%. 95%, wanalala, Bishop, they are sleeping. They do not want to think. They do not want to do anything. They are just there. So practice rising up early in the morning, because early in the morning is the best time to think, is the best time to write books, is the best time to plan for your day. And once you do that, the vision is going to be clear. And then we also address the entrepreneurs, the career people. Don't just live because you are following the people. Have that personal purpose, personal vision. Why are you here on earth? If you ask me, George Washiri, why are you here on earth? I am here on earth to make the world a better place. Whatever I do, whether it's in my church, whether it's in the Optivate, I must leave an impact, a legacy. The same way, Bishop, you do. For you, legacy is already seed. Yani, umesha jenga foundation. Because you have worked for God for over 50 years, your children are now picked up. And that's something personally I desire. You know, seeing my son around here and my, you know, it's very nice. Because you are happy. And that vision, you have to claim it, you have to write it, you have to call it, and then follow it up. And then I also tell people, never compete. The world is something I call abundance mentality. There is enough for everyone. Like for us, we're in real estate. I tell my people, there are only two companies in Kenya for real estate, Optiven and others. So when you come to Optiven, don't say so and so is doing. No, we are competing with ourselves. And for you who is there, that particular office, don't compete with the people. Make yourself better. Do self-development. Read the books. They say people who read books control the world, and the time you stop learning, you die. That's what I tell people. And once you do that, success is going to be evident. Whatever you touch, you will prosper. Because uko na mpangilio, you have the focus. Because the reason why I failed so many times, Bishop, I lacked something called focus. And I picked a lesson that if you focus, you become like a magnifying glass. When you're in school, if you ukimulika hiyo karatasi hapa inashomeka. The power of focus. And I also ask entrepreneurs out there, focus on what you do. Do it so well that when people are looking for property, the first thing that comes in your mind is Optivate. And that's what you do at Optivate. We keep that particular focus, Bishop.
No, I'm getting you so well. One would even be tempted to think you're a member of the House of Bread, from the way you are talking and the way that I've been, I talk to our people about never competing with anybody and being good at whatever you are doing, being the best at whatever you are doing. I think that is very, very encouraging. And we need to speak to our young people who think there are so many pastors who are failing because they saw Mark Kariuki and on TV and they want to be Mark Kariuki, but they have no idea where I came from. And they have no idea what time I wake up in the morning. They have no idea how I start my day. So I'm getting you that you've got to start with an idea. And you know, I've always said, Jesus told us, when you pray, say, our Father who art in heaven, and hallowed be thy name, give us this day our daily bread. And many times we think that the daily bread is manna from heaven, while actually is an idea. That God gives you an idea, and you concentrate on that idea, and that idea comes to manifestation. What I'm looking at now is that even after failing for 15 times, you never gave up.
Wow. Bishop, and our viewers, even after going through, by the way, I was depressed. I had a depression.
Mm-hmm.
And I must thank my pastor, Philip Katutu.
Mm-hmm.
And I also must thank Dr. Wale Akinyemi.
Mm-hmm.
I remember one time I was really down, yani.
Mm.
And I called Leverett, I think he was pastor before, Dr. Wale Akinyemi.
Mm-hmm.
I asked him, please give me 5 sessions. Mm. I just want and come and speak to you.
Mm.
And he called me Serena.
Mm.
Can you imagine?
Hey.
The guy under the weather, I made it to Serena. We give Serena. Hey. Kusafi. Mm. Kuzuri. I don't know how to ananiona mimi ni mchafu.
Mm.
So the doctor was there. I can order a coffee. Mm. Nikakunywa coffee pale.
Mm.
And then I poured my heart.
Mm.
But I remember one thing that the doctor Akinyemi told me.
Mm.
Optivine will be like Coca-Cola.
Mm.
One time we'll go to this city, we'll see billboards.
Mm.
People we playing football, we'll see sponsored by Optivine.
Mm.
That thing has happened this year. If you go to this city, Bishop, there is no highway we don't have the Optivine billboard.
Mm-hmm.
Inspiring possibilities.
Mm-hmm.
Optivine, inspiring possibilities.
Mm-hmm.
And those words really inspired me,
mm-hmm.
put power on me,
mm-hmm.
and they still ring in my mind.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why I ask the young people there, if you are there, maybe your business went down, find somebody who can speak to you.
Mm-hmm.
Listen to YouTube of Mark, Bishop Mark Kariuk. By the way, I'm your listener.
Oh.
Listen to those YouTube.
Mm.
Go there, subscribe. Listen with a notebook, a pen, and put some points.
Mm.
Meditate on those words, because you are what you read, you are what you listen.
Mm.
If you're out there, you are saying, I think life is tough. Find that particular mentor. It could be a virtual mentor, it could be a physical mentor.
Mm.
And one of the most urgent mentors is our pastors.
Mm.
Because when we have issues, we come to you.
Mm.
I go to my pastor. And that one can be able to support our young people. And I know there are many who have gone to university.
Mm.
There are no jobs.
Mm.
I encourage them. Think of something that you can do,
even
wherever you are, whether you're in the village, whether you're in the city, think of something. If you feel lonely, look for a good partner.
Mm.
Brainstorm the ideas. What can we do? Brainstorm.
Mm.
The other day I was talking to about 5 architects.
Mm.
They left the university, no jobs. Because big architects are taking all the jobs from government. And maybe you address the major body, NMS.
Mm.
Please, major, consider these young graduates, engineers. They can be able to be given some work to do.
Mm.
And I told them, please don't just stay home.
Mm.
Register a company.
Mm.
And they actually, I think it's 6, I have been doing mentorship for them for 6 months. Mm. As we talk, they have already registered a company.
Mm-hmm.
We give them the first assignment, and they've done a good job.
Mm.
And these are young people.
Mm.
So if you are there, if you are lonely, you can't do anything alone, you can be able to get your partners, your friends, and do something together. You can even start your own website and start marketing Optivine products right there.
Mm.
Because I believe there are so many things that we can do as a nation, as young people.
Mm.
So if you are there, don't stay idle. Please do something. Use social capital. Deuteronomy 8:18 says it is a God who gives us power to create wealth.
Mm.
That power is what I talked about, or what Bishop is talking about, the ideas, the energy, you know, the thoughts.
Mm.
And we can be able to change this country, because this country is not going to change because the government is creating jobs. Actually, the government has no jobs.
Mm.
And that's why for us at Optivine, we say we exist to economically and socially empower and transform the communities.
Mm.
One of our goals is to create 30,000 jobs, because the people to create jobs is not government.
Mm.
It's you and me.
Mm.
Because once you have a company, you get people to work for you, you are creating these opportunities. And all those graduates out there, I believe everybody can do something.
Mm.
And I also, let's get government involved. If you have an idea, we have some government platforms whereby you can apply for funding.
Mm.
There are those platforms, they say, we are favoring the youth. Go there and yell. Say, hey, mi nataka kazi hapa.
Mm.
And I can tell you, we now have some ministries that are considering the young people in terms of giving them business. Talk to Optivine. You know, for us, our population is, they're all young people. We hire young people.
Mm.
We hire them and train them.
Mm.
You know, follow us on Facebook.
Mm.
When you have opportunities, apply. Say, hey, I saw you on One Accord TV.
Mm.
I'll give you a hearing. Why not?
Mm.
Yes.
What I'm hearing you say is that it is very, very important to have a mentor and to choose who to listen to.
Yes.
Because if you listen to the wrong person, you will be led. You will be led away.
Yes,
so, the listening or the choosing has always got to have a beginning.
Yes.
There could be some viewers there who are saying, "Okay, now who do I listen to? Nobody's here is hearing me."
Mm.
But you maybe if you're able to give them your contact,
yes.
Octaven contact, how they can get to you, because you have gone through the process.
Yes.
You have gone through the process, and I had them say you don't want to reinvent a wheel if it's already there.
Yes.
Maybe they can be able to contact you, or who they can contact, you know, Octaven.
Thank you, Bishop. And you're asking, you know, maybe they're asking, how do I get a mentor? You get a mentor based on your passion.
Mm-hmm.
So for me, I am passionate about job creation, passionate about changing people's lives. And when I was looking for my mentor, I checked, are there people in this country that are transforming lives? These are my mentors.
Mm-hmm.
The first person who came to my mind was Dr. James Mwangi.
Mm-hmm.
And I say, this man, I must see him.
Mm-hmm.
I tried to go through all the channels, I couldn't.
Mm-hmm.
But I discovered, I saw in the newspaper, he had a big meeting in Safari Park, and people were paying 5,000. It was an investment meeting. I looked for the money, I paid. I really wanted to be just near Dr. James Mwangi. I tried to go on the front seats. I was removed. Yeah, these are VIPs, so nikarudisha huko. Lakini I timed him. Nikampata. Within 30 seconds, my name is George Washuri. And we are partnering with Equity Bank. And Dr. Ali, this is my card. When you have time, you can call me. Good enough. After a few days, he called me. And I had a whole 15 minutes with Dr. James Mwangi. He inspired me. He served me tea. Can you imagine? And that really inspired me. Why? He is online. And I said, I want to come closer to this person because of the way he takes risk, the way he creates jobs. And I did it. Nowadays, it's easy to meet him. It's a call away. Then the other person, because I like helping people, was Dr. Manu Shadaria. So I also tried to go to his office. It was not easy. But I discovered these powerful people, they always have got networks, meetings. I discovered he had a meeting at Pan-Africa. I went there. Purposely to meet him, and those are the greetings, and to greet him. I went there, I met him, and we talked. I told him, Dr. Shadaria, I admire the way you do your foundation. You go to the University of Nairobi, donated by Manu Shadaria. Aga Khan, donated by Manu Shadaria. We had a talk. Today, even yesterday, we talked.
Allah.
I'm able to get access. The other person is Vimal Shah. Vimal Shah, because of the impact he has done in Kenya Private Sector Alliance, you know, helping people, helping organizations. Those are my three physical mentors. I have also virtual mentors. Virtual mentors is one of them is Brian Tracy. You know, I watch his videos in terms of the way he markets. The other virtual mentor is John Maxwell, his leadership. The books, I've read almost all his books. So are you there? What is your passion? Find people who are within your passion. Look for them. They say, if you want to find anybody in this world, you only require three steps. Somebody who knows that person. Right now, it's so easy to meet everyone, anyone, because there are so many Zoom forums with the ministers, big people, Bill Gates, all these big people. Register. Be on that Zoom meeting. And then when Bishop Mark Kariuki is talking, you are commenting, hey, Bishop, that's a good point. When can I come and see you? Hapo tukwa chatline.
Yeah.
Of course, your people are reading and say, hey, I see this fellow called George Washuri commenting. Can you ask him to see me? That's how people get appointments. So if you're there, don't say you don't have networks. Networks are here. Yeah, and I do it, by the way. The other day was a meeting hosted by a very senior US businessman. I went there. I was commenting. And he gave me his email. You know, he finances projects.
Yeah.
We are now talking. So are you there? You can be able to identify that particular passion, identify your passion, find a person who is lining to you. And for me, if you want to get in touch with me, I'm available online. My Facebook is George Washuri, with very many followers. My YouTube is George Washuri. And I do FB Live once a week. So you can be able to engage me. And then our offices is Absa Plaza, 14th floor. You can come there and speak to us. And my phone is 0716 605410 or 0790300300, 0790300300. I am very much pleasant in terms of online, and I am so happy that we are going to change, especially Christian career people, Christian business people, because why should you suffer? Why should you fail? And you have this program, One Accord TV. Share with somebody this link from One Accord TV. Why? You can help that particular person to get some ideas on how to build up a big business. Bishop, when I look at Kenya today, we have Chinese coming to Kenya. We have Germans coming to Kenya. Why are they coming to Kenya? Yet, most of our young people, they spend so much time on political platforms saying, me, I'm on this side, I'm on this side. Please, change your association.
Jump out of the box.
Jump out of the politics. Go to business forums. Some of you need to left some of WhatsApp because they are poisonous WhatsApps. Join WhatsApps. Like for One Accord WhatsApp, whereby people are discussing ideas. That way, we grow. Today in Kenya, I was reading what His Excellency Uhuru Kenyatta has done. I was amazed the kind of infrastructure that is happening. We have the Express Superhighway. This one, we are not paying a cent. So somebody is building. We use it for 30 years. It's called BOT, Build, Operate, and Transfer. Then our children will get it. We have Keno, Duo College, opening 5 counties in Central Kenya. You saw Kisumu Bishop. Development, why? Because the president, salamu, sio siyasa. Salamu, we are peaceful and we are able to develop. Development means businesses are open up. Look at real estate, where open is. Real estate, we have not even started. The other day I went to Istanbul, I was shocked. The town is 183 kilometers in length, 18 kilometers in width. Yet, I see some media people saying bust. Bust from where? There is no bust, no property bust. Why? Every Kenyan person requires a home. And if you look at the way people are building in Kitengela, like our project in Little Garden, Kiambu, people want homes. And if you are there, you are thinking about real estate. There is no competition. The market is virgin. Look at entertainment. You know, we opened one of the biggest entertainment centers in Kitengela called GMC Place, whereby you are hosting 1,000 people on a Sunday. The people come there because there's no other facility. Why can't you open such a facility in Kagundo Road? Why can't you, those who are listening, open that facility in Nakuru? Because after working so hard, families require somewhere for children. So entertainment is a big industry. Look at restaurants. I know there's COVID, but we run restaurant, we are still selling because now we are now doing delivery to the houses. Look at logistics, for example. You know, the other day I saw a friend of mine starting in Uganda, Sedi, a company called Sedi. Boda that are trusted, they are secure. Why can't we start it in Kenya? So opportunities are there. Look at the car washes. Everybody has got a car, lakini hakuna mahali ya kuoshea, hakuna maji. Why can't you find out? How can you lease somewhere? You start washing people's cars, and you can lease even washing machines. You start making money. So, Bishop, our people and ourselves, we need to open up our mind, see the opportunities available in Kenya, even before you go to Tanzania. And we must thank Uhuru Kenyatta, because right now, you can easily go to Tanzania without victimization after that meeting. Burundi. Burundi is a virgin country. And that's where we find people like our mentors, Equity Bank. They're in DRC Congo. Opportunities are there. But most of our businesses, including Optivate, Radio Bishop tukakasirika, tukasema nitoka kwenda NSE, so that we capture 20 African countries. I want to challenge people in business. Forget about being a village champion. Oh, we have won awards, top SME in Kenya. That's nothing. Go and conquer Africa. Be like Dagote. Dagote is a man like us, two hearts with two eyes, and the guy is conquering Africa. And for us, Bishop, for Optivate, those are our benchmark. We want in the next, by the year 2041, we want Optivate to be in over 20 African countries. It is possible, it's doable, we can feel it, we can see it, the vision is clear. If Optivate, founded by a boy from Kieni, who slept 5 days without food, what about you? You can make it, you can do it. Have that vision, have that passion, pray, partner with God, register that foundation, and I can tell you, you can make it, because there is God in heaven. Yes.
Well, viewers, I'm sure you have got, you have captured something. This has just been great. You just can't go to bed the way you always do. You have got to sit down before you go to bed or even before you eat. Some of you may not even eat. You leave that food there and say, now, my head, you have got to work. My head, you have got to think. Because there is, you don't have porridge in here. Mm. You've got to know you don't have porridge in here. Your life can change. And God ordained that you listen to this program tonight so that your life may change, that you may think outside the box, that you may get new ideas, that you may get in contact with people like George who can be able to stir you up and your life changes completely. You know, we are so grateful. Apparently, time moves so fast on Wednesdays.
Yes.
I don't know why the time doesn't move that fast on Tuesdays, but on Wednesday nights, it moves so fast. Mm. But I must say, it's been a great pleasure to have you, with us. And what you have shared is so powerful. So we have just about maybe 30 seconds. Where can someone get your books?
Wow, this book is for business people. It's a very interesting book. And this is not a book. It's a secret of what has made Optiven the way it is.
Mm-hmm.
If you replicate, they say success can be replicated.
Mm-hmm.
Success can be copied. If you replicate all the principles in this particular book, unleash your full potential,
mm-hmm.
you only replicate. You know, what is business?
Mm.
The vision, the passion, the values.
Mm.
I can tell you, your business will grow. It's available at our offices, APSA Plaza, 14th floor, or Textbook Center on Amazon.
Mm.
The book is available, 1,500. Once you buy this particular book, your name changes. You become George Washiri, philanthropist. You become Reverend Dan Kariuki, philanthropist.
Mm.
Because the money goes to the foundation to support the less fortunate, the orphans, the widows.
Mm.
The other book is The Story of George Washiri. You read this one. If you don't shed a tear, you must be a brother or a sister of a Pharaoh.
Mm. Yeah.
It is an amazing book. You read it, you cry, and within 2 hours, Umeimariza.
Mm.
It is so sweet to read.
Mm.
And today I have honor to donate these two books to the person we value in Kenya at Optiven, none other than our own Bishop Mark Kariuki. You do this, you'll be very inspired, Bishop.
Oh, thank you. Yeah. Thank you so very much. I receive it, and I'm so grateful for this book. Man, you will see my life change after I read these books.
Yes.
Oh, you will read stories about me. You know, read stories about me, but don't let me go alone. We can go together. We can read together. If there's anything that has helped me,
yes.
is reading books.
Yes.
Reading books has really, really helped me, and I really appreciate for these books.
Thank you
so very much for creating time to come and be with
Thank
us.
You.
I'm looking forward to partnering with you,
yes.
so that we can change lives.
Sure.
That is my passion. That's my dream.
Mm-hmm.
And it is so exciting when you meet somebody and they tell me, you know, you changed my life.
Yes.
You know, you said this one day and my life was changed.
Mm-hmm.
And I've experienced that quite a lot.
Mm-hmm.
And thank you so very much. I hope our viewers, you have benefited tonight from Mr. George Washiri, and I hope that you will get in touch. I has given you the number. It's right there on the screen. You can get in touch with him or with Octaven, and just enjoy yourself. Once again, this is Open Talk with your pastor and your friend, Bishop Mark Kariuki, your friend for a long time. The Lord bless you. Have a super, super night. You talk or I talk or we hear one another. We move forward. God bless you.
Amen.
Thank you so very much.
Amen.
Amen.